Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining our webinar, The Next Generation of Embedded Systems Data Management. Today, we have prepared some exciting material that relates to the Internet of Things, evolution of the embedded systems, and the importance of real-time data. Where are we going from this evolution? And we will be sharing with you what we are witnessing and what we are learning working with the customers. And the importance of data processing and data management challenges for the connected world, for the new autonomous autonomy and all the intelligent embedded systems that we are all building. I will also share with you what we have done. We have been working really hard. Our research and development team been really engaged for past few years to prepare us to offer a solution that it's suited for real-time data management, whether you are using microcontrollers, MCUs, or microprocessors. What we also have prepared, we have invited Mr. Albrecht Bochmann from Bitcontrol. He is the chief technology officer who went through the same process of looking for a data management solution for their smart factory automation application, which is called Flex Control. And he had to decide how to manage the data for the smart factory automation application, which is a very important industrial application utilized by various companies, including General Electric. So at the end, he's going to explain for us the challenges. He's going to introduce us to the steps that he took, and he will share with us his vision with regards to where they are going with their progress. But to start with, the number of devices and embedded systems that you know, we are seeing are really growing exponentially. And we see the expansion, more and more of these devices are getting connected, and they start, you know, talking to each other. They start, you know, producing data. So the data management and the data management, safety, security, these are all challenges that, you know, they're arriving for us. You know, it's not only smartphones that needs to be smart anymore. Embedded systems needs to be smart. Your vehicle need to be smart. Your medical device need to be smart. The industrial robots, you know, and other embedded systems, one by one, are lining up to gain intelligence. And because of the autonomy and because of the connectivity that we have upon us, we need to prepare ourselves and ask, okay, what do we do and how do we deal with data? I was just reading in somewhere on the Business Insight, Fortune Business Insight, that the global Internet of Things market, it's projected to grow from 500 billion this year to 22,500 billion in the year 2029. And because many of these, you know, embedded applications that we have, many of these IoT systems that they have, they all are gaining intelligence. They all are going to deal with the data. They need to be able to store the data. They need to be able to understand the data, and they need to be able to secure the data. And it's important for us to be able to prepare ourselves and ask what are the important fundamentals that we need to pay attention. And the concept of time series data management really, really gets attention in here. So the time dimension, it's going to play an important role. So we store the event information, and we're also going to relate it to the time that it's going to play an important role for us. There are examples of, you know, different things that's happening around us. We are having autonomous vehicle that is reshaping the world. We have autonomous drones in the aerospace space and in the industry that, you know, they are thinking about, you know, using them for delivering packages. So instead of mailman coming to our door, you know, giving the package, the drones are arriving and they will have our package. When you go to healthcare, you know, you will see that this embedded systems that we are building are going to be autonomous, and you know, the doctors are getting replaced by the kiosks that we go for our annual check. Robotics are already doing the surgery. You know, I was in San Francisco actually a couple of years ago, and I learned that these are these robots that they can do the surgery much more precise than a regular surgeon, which is really interesting to me. And then the body scanning and everything that, you know, we will see around us, it's going to get, you know, interact somehow, some way with the embedded systems. And I even just, you know, heard that, you know, these embedded systems, our doctors are thinking about, you know, in putting them and tracking us with these embedded systems that they can be aware of our health and they can improve our health. So all these things are indicating that we are arriving to the new era, arriving era that robots are going to play a role. Robots are going to deal with the data. You know, all these things are becoming intelligent and all these things are going to interact with the data. And we will see that robots and humans are going to interact. That it is interesting, you know, interaction between human and robots is happening, yes. And you will see that we are going to pay attention to important components that are going to be important, that they all, you know, relate to the data that, you know, we are dealing with. And the question that we ask ourselves is, okay, with this new era that arriving on us, what are the downsides? You know, we understand some really important information that's coming to us. For example, a car manages 25 gigabytes of data in 1 hour. An airplane engine, a 737, you know, has 20 terabytes of data that comes its way per hour. An industrial robot, 205 of terabytes per data, and they all need to process, they need to manage it, and it's all need to be secured. So how is this world changing on us? It's changing very interesting. You know, when we were talking about vehicles, when we were talking about carjacking in the past, carjacking was, you know, let's just build a very strong lock for the door so, you know, the car becomes safe. But no longer that's the case. You need to have a strong lock and need to make sure that the car doesn't get hacked. So what happens if someone steals the car? You will see someone hacking into a car, taking over the vehicle, and you know, they can get a control on the vehicle. So we need to pay attention to that. When you build the drones that I shared with you earlier that you want to use for delivery purposes, you need to make sure that, you know, somebody doesn't steal it and, you know, take it to the different address than that was anticipated. So the medical devices, the devices are, you know, becoming intelligent. They're going to work with the outside somehow, some ways, and they are going to deal with lots of data. We need to make sure that, you know, they are not getting hacked, they are secure, all the data is getting processed well, and all the data is managed well. So all the positives and negative things that are coming our way, indicating that a massive amount of raw data is getting generated in these embedded systems and devices, and they are doing it because all this massive data needs to be able to, we need to make sense out of it. For the systems that we are building, we need to gain insight, we need to obtain intelligence, and we need to predict faults. And there is a and if you want to do, you know, advanced maintenance, all these things need to happen if it doesn't already in the embedded systems. So the new innovation that is on our way, it's going to fantastic possibilities for solving complex problems and generating revenue, and generating revenue for the systems that we are building. So when you look at the IoT market, the data is pasting the, it's really in outpacing the data management, the data safety, the data security. And it's important to have the right foundation in place for data management. Data is growing really fast and things are getting connected. And there are so many ways that devices need to gain intelligence and they need to be able to benefit from the right embedded data management platform that's in place. So, with this huge amount of data, security is important, safety is important, and also getting ready for the next generation of data management is important. So what we are learning, your foundation that you know your applications need to be prepared for. So when you talk about the mission critical embedded systems, its criticality is important, safety is important, security important. These are four fundamentals in addition to being able to you know certify your application. So mission critical embedded systems need to be safe, they need to be secure, and they need to be reliable in a way that your industry can prepare your application for tomorrow. And these key elements are something that you know we have learned from the market and we are preparing ourselves for, and we are sharing it with you because you need to be able to, you know, whether you're building application with microcontrollers, whether it's microprocessors inside the embedded systems, the right fundamental data management also needs to prepare you for these four foundations so you can analyze the data, you can sense the data, you can detect event from huge amount of raw data that comes your way and only store the meaningful information. And these are the important things that you know we need to have. In addition to that, it's important for us to share with you that what we are learning, it's indicating to us that modern embedded systems that you're building, they also need to be secure. You need to make sure that the security is addressed from the connectivity perspective. You need to make sure that the data is safe and nobody can get into the system from outside. For example, also from the physical perspective, you need to make sure that the hardware is not reachable, so you lock the equipment. From the access controls, nobody can access the hardware. Or when you are building the system, you want to make sure that the operating system is saved, so nobody can allow and target and hack the operating system. And the most importantly, you need to make sure that your application is safe and your application pays attention to all the safety. And guess what? Finally, you need to make sure that all the data generated in the safe system is secured and it has a right data management platform, embedded data management platform that can make sure that it's providing you the security that your application you deserve. So the question that you may ask is, okay, what has it changed? What we are seeing here is that we are seeing that devices are becoming like human beings. They want to be able to sense the data. They want to be able to understand the data. Whether you're building an autonomous vehicle that sees the exit sign and says it must turn out, or whether you're building a system for environmental analysis, so when there's a fire that you need to be notified, they all are telling us that they need to be able to understand massive amount of data. They need to be able to sense it. They need to be able to analyze it. So basically, you need to be able to inject intelligence into your systems in a secure way so they can address the needs that you have, and they need to be able to also communicate with other systems. So IoT devices and mission critical systems are constantly producing data. And this data, it comes in a real time and it needs to be safe and it needs to be processed. And it needs to be able to help the system to make a decision. And it needs to be able to offer running queries for analytical purposes. So, and embedded IoT data management platform aids greatly to improve the operational performance and reduce the cost with excellent data ingestion and data query. So what we did with our technology, ETIDB, we paid close attention with the performance, really high throughput, super low latency, and a small footprint if you're building an application that, you know, needs to be ready for the era that I shared with you. So the query rate, the ingestion rate, and even the export rate, because, you know, these systems are just getting deployed out there and they want to minimize the interaction with the outside. And when they want to communicate, the export rate should be really, really fast. So whether you're building embedded applications for, you know, MCUs and MPUs, these are the fundamentals that, you know, we have learned. And in order to just to introduce you to what we have, we have many people that are new to us today, and we provide two different database technologies. We provide ETIDB IoT, which is a secure embedded data management SDK for mission critical embedded systems that are built on microcontrollers. So MCUs with ETIDB IoT, and ETIDB SQL, it's our technology for microprocessors, whether it's a single core or multi-core. That's a fantastic solution for building a data management platform. It has a very powerful cockpit that allows you to design and manage the time series data. It provides high availability, and whether any processors, any chipset, or any real-time operating system that you are using, we are able to work with you because we made this independent to the hardware and RTOS. So the solution that we have, it's focused for embedded systems to monitor, to sense, and gather the data, whether this is the logging data, whether this is the configuration data, whether you are, you want to have event detection, or whatever your intelligent or your system require, we are trying to address that at the embedded level for microprocessor, for microcontroller, with ETIDB and ETIDB SQL. Now, let me share with you an interesting scenario. You know, I just talked about that, you know, it no longer, you know, we need to have our phones to be smart. We need to also have our, you know, vehicles or cars to be smart. In the auto industry, manufacturings that they are building, you know, automotive, they are interested in capturing as much as possible data, whether that the data relates to, you know, the inside, the or the environment outside, or the application that it's residing inside the vehicle. This data is going to help them to provide a better car, better maintenance experience. They can deploy these cars, you know, throughout all different geographical area. And at the end of the day, they want to generate revenue. So in order to do that, they need to be able to make their systems, which is a vehicle, interesting so they can offer value with various things. So they need to be able to collect the different data from environment, they need to be able to collect data from the vehicle itself, and they need to be able to collect vehicle for the applications. Why is that? Because more of these systems, more of this, you know, smart systems like smart vehicles, they are built with microcontrollers and MCUs, and they want to be able to monitor the part, they want to be able to gain insight, and they want to be able to store a meaningful information. So the sensors that they are connected to the outside supply environmental data, and these are again all built with MCUs and MPUs, and they are providing real-time information. And there are also, you know, sensors that are connected inside the car that they provide information such as information about the brake, battery usage, transmission, etc. So what we are seeing here is that we are saying that the drivers are also have applications that they are installed, whether that's related to their own interest or their family members or other passengers. they are all producing tremendous amount of data that this data needs to be captured, need to be stored, and needs to be converted to revenue for these vehicle manufacturers so they can go back and sell it and they can provide more pleasant vehicle owning experience or driving experience. So realizing the financial benefits of all these MCUs and MPUs that they go to the embedded system, that in our case, it's it's a vehicle. It's important for us to see that, you know, this is going to help us to generate insight, operational efficiency, and make sense of the data that comes from various parts of, and build a better world. So in order to do that, for past couple of years, we have been really busy with our R&D team, and we are excited to introduce you to various new things that we have invented and developed. One of the things that we have done is our streaming engine. That is part of it. We have our database has two different engines, and one of them is the data management engine, and the other one is a streaming engine, which is a very robust way to detect and respond to sensors and application events. These events are data patterns that reveal more complex circumstances. They're predictable, and for sudden change in the temperature, sudden change in the pressure, or any metrics that relate to your application that becomes dysfunctional, boom, you know, the database engine, the streaming, it's going to inform you about that. And, you know, it can be also relating to motion detectors that, you know, you wanted to watch a movement of a signal and turn it into, you know, something that can be meaningful for you. And so before we build this streaming engine for our embedded database, we noticed that manufacturers, you know, they had to go through constructing this costly way of proprietary application to collect the data, use decision logic to detect an event, and then trigger another application to relate to the event. And these are all, you know, IOs that they're all going to be costly. And not only they add more to the complexity, they also, you know, make the application store. So as a result, we have introduced this new engine that allows the MCUs and MPUs to detect the events across you know, hundreds of sensors within an embedded systems. So with our real-time data processing embedded systems, and may act promptly by continuously processing streams of data created by sensors and other devices that you are using in your embedded platform. And ETIDB allows you to store both real-time and non-real-time. It's pretty important because the real-time data, which it's the moving situation, or the non-real-time, which is a static operation, they all have this dynamic infrastructure that they bring to the embedded systems, and you want to make sure that your database manage that, and ETIDB can do that. So as when sensors are pulling data from various MCUs and MPUs, you are prepared to manage the data, and you're able to go through massive amount of data stream and refine them and only keep the important information that's important for you. And the entire value from various nodes that you have different trends of data collection methods, they determine, you know, how to optimize your system and how you allow your systems to act. And since many of these embedded systems need to collect on the microsecond or sometimes even millisecond or nanosecond, you want to make sure that your system is ready to communicate with this massive amount of raw data, understand it, gain insight, and process that for you so you can intelligently filter and process the data in any quantity that comes in your way. One of the most important things that I shared with you, in addition to, you know, being able to process the data, being able to go through the stream of data, that, you know, it's that your understanding from the market, it's security. Security is not a feature. Security needs to be handled from multi-dimension. And a secure data management solution in the connected world that I explained for you earlier, it needs to be a procedure that you develop over time to ensure that you are always available to meet the challenges that, you know, coming your way from the security perspective. IKEA SDL is a security development layer that we began, you know, by training our staff, going through all different processes of the security and working to writing a secure code from the outset. So we pay close attention to the requirement for developing a secure piece of software, secure frame model, and we guarantee that we want to make sure that, you know, we understand the attack that is surfaces on different gaps, and we pay attention to the validation and coding standards. And IKEA SDL Conformant is the only embedded data management platform in the world that support IEC ISO 62443. And with this valuable offering, you know, you can build and securely deploy your application with peace of mind. And, you know, this itself from the IKEA SDL perspective that that I shared with you from the security development lifecycle, it has various components. You know, you have to identify and prioritize the security risk. You have to have a secure design. There are considerations in building each features and components that, you know, you have to pay attention. It's coding practices with regards to security, security testing. All these things have been paid attention at the data management level. So with peace of mind, you can build this data. And this is just one dimension that I'm sharing with you, because as you're collecting data, as you're sharing data, you want to make sure that various different multi-dimension security technique, that's a better way, multi-dimensional security techniques are paid attention for protecting and building your system. So this is from the development perspective, but, you know, also what we have done, we have prepared ourselves with the protections and the attack taxonomy. So the device cannot be vulnerable, and we provide various opportunities for managing security for the embedded systems. The multidimensional methodology that I explained to you, it requires maintaining, developing security, maintaining security, and updating security. And another thing that, you know, we have done is encryption. Encryption is one of the several powerful defenses that you can use to safeguard the database communication. And encryption techniques play an essential role, because data transformation is difficult for unauthorized user to reverse. And AES that stands for Advanced Encryption Standard. It's something that, you know, the US government introduced, and we currently they're using it across the world. And the algorithm, you know, it's deployed very successfully, and it's one of the first fundamental guards that we developed with ETIDB, and AES 128 and 256, it's available for the developers. And also when it comes to IoT systems, authentication, it's important. Authentication by the operating systems, authentication using SSL, and authentication by the database. So authentication prevents eavesdropping, unauthorized interception, and session hijacking. You remember when you had this autonomous car? You know, it's important to pay attention to all those things. And SCRAM, the SALT, I think it's SALTed Challenge Response Authentication Mechanism, that's abbreviation for SCRAM, is a password-based mutual authentication mechanism that helps for, you know, monitoring the eavesdropping or make the attacks more difficult. And that's something that also it's available with our technology when you use ETIDB SQL. And on top of everything, we have invested tremendous amount of resources to build an agent. And this is the agent that we call it ETIDB security agent, known as ETIDB SEAL. The DB SEAL monitors the database activities and automatically isolate the database from the attack, and decide between our alternatives to mitigate an attack, and keeps the database content always available. It's a proactive monitoring of the data and the database by this agent that allow the device to be prepared, you know, send an alert, block the access or shut down, or however your application decides. They are the metrics that can be controlled by you when your application, you know, gets deployed. It's a virtual agent that monitors the database responsibility and the metrics that they are into that. And with the DBSeal, you know, there are a couple important things that I shared with you. One was the ETL STL with the ISO 62443. And the other one is this DBSeal, which is the security agent that, you know, I just introduced to you. So basically, this security that you pay attention for your coding, the security that, you know, you pay attention for, you know, for different dimensions, and also with this security agent that monitors the database queries and follows the, you know, instruction that you have. Ensures the data to be kept with highest integrity, and you can still operate the application and communicate and process the data. Attack like SQL control hijacking that's well known can be controlled, and you can run the device with the peace of mind that it's rejecting the unwanted SQL hijackers. And this is another tool that we know we have provided in addition to data encryption, authentication, and the ETL/STL that can tremendously benefit. And the other thing that you need to know as a developer of this embedded systems is you need to have your device highly available. So when there's a disaster, you need to have recovery challenges. And this is another feature that we have introduced with ETLDB for embedded systems to be highly available. So data should not get lost when there is a power interruption. And ETLDB supports for high availability ensures that when there's a power failure, when there is a catastrophic network failure, when there are maintenance issues, data and database are always accessible and available. And it supports high availability that includes data consistency, data redundancy, fallback, and fall detection. And the ETLDB data distribution shares the data to protect the systems of devices. And redundancy is a key aspect for high availability that allows the data actually to be kept in more than one device or one location to eliminate there's something that we call single point of failure. And high availability is often used in powerful servers, you know, that they're deploying, but we brought that to the embedded system that it's at the embedded level to protect the critical data. And so when you deploy your device, you can, you know, be you can have this peace of mind. So before I pass it to Mr. Altman, I also want to introduce you a couple more things. One is that we build the ETLDB for various markets. You know, whether you are building solutions with MCUs and MPUs that are part of this intelligent embedded evolution, monitoring, analyzing, streaming the data for your equipment with high performance capability, it requires the data-centric approach that you know we have been I just talked about. The ETL embedded database and the consulting expertise that you provide has been proven in various markets. And whether you are building application for automotive, whether it's industrial automation, whether it's medical devices, or even remote control environment systems, they can truly benefit. And we are really proud to see our customers enjoying this offering. And the last thing that I want to share with you, if you want to work with us, if you want to have our expertise to be shared, we do have senior experts that they work at no cost to work with the customers, to review the specification requirements that they have. All you need to do is just, you know, send an email to info@ittia.com with the subject that called Brainstorm with ETIA. So when you send that email, one of our senior agent, one of our senior, you know, staff will work with you to understand your requirement, understand your needs, and work with you very closely to share with you what we have learned. It's very important for us to share with you what we have learned for the past many years working in the embedded data management sector and working with embedded customers, so you can tremendously save lots of time and energy and benefit from what is available for you at no cost. So now, as I shared with you, let me introduce you to a really cool application from BitControl that's called Flex Control. And Flex Control, as I shared with you, is an industrial automation, and it's a system that is built for modern smart factory automation. Through the coming years, you will hear more and more. As I said, this successful application, it's getting good attention, and we have invited the chief technical officer from BitControl to share with us the challenges that they went through and how they build their embedded data management platform, and how he can assist us to understand the benefit of utilizing an embedded technology like ETIDB SQL for their system. Mr. Altman, go ahead, please.
Thank you, Mr. Montessori. Thank you for the opportunity to present our solution here in this webinar. And a warm welcome to the audience also from my side. I'm going to present to you our product Flex Control. And I'm from the company BitControl Systems in Leipzig in Germany. You can see our web address here at the bottom of the page, where you can get also more information about our company. What is Flex Control? Flex Control is a middleware solution that is targeting industrial automation systems in a variety of markets. So it's essentially brand neutral. And it is a highly modular system, and it is built with a two-tier architecture to optimize the usage of procedures. I'm going to explain that in the next slide. It is used in process industry, for instance, gas, water, energy distribution, chemical industry, and as well as in the smart factory, which is our topic today. The important point is that we have a seamless cooperation of the two tiers, and that allows you to create a very powerful solution, because you can span multiple levels of the automation stack with a single product, and that will operate reliably 24 hours, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, which is obviously a very important point in the industry. Flex Control can be viewed as an edge computing platform. And here I'm going to explain to you our two-tier architecture. You see there is a real-time part and a non-real-time part, which have dedicated target tasks. With the real-time part, we are doing time-critical data acquisition and tight control loops that operate very close to the factory floor, and the system is able to run at a 1 millisecond cycle time, which is common in the industry at the factory floor. The non-real-time part is meant for mass data processing, mass data storage, and it is used for a large-scale connectivity to upper layer systems like MES, which is Manufacturing Execution System, or ERP, which is Enterprise Resource Planning System, and generally to the cloud. Because of the different tasks, there are different connectivity options of the two parts. The real-time part operates with telecontrol protocols that are standardized across industry, for instance, Modbus or the IEC 61870. And it can also operate via serial connections or via regular networks. The system can operate industrial field buses like EtherCAT, Profinet, or Profibus. And also the real-time part has a generic HTTPS interface to connect systems that don't comply to these standardized industrial interfaces. The non-real-time part has its main interface called OPC UA, which is also standardized in IEC 61541, which is basically the main language of Industry 4.0. And we also have a generic HTTPS interface, and we have an internal interface which is called UKP. It stands for Universal Communication API, and that interface is trimmed for speed and allows a seamless connection of the two parts. Of course, you want to process data at each level, and you have different processing options. So the real-time part has the IEC 61138 programming language implemented, which is basically the PLC programming, and everybody in industrial automation knows this language. You have a native C++ SDK that allows you to create your own applications. I will talk about that later. And you have the ability to work with SQL. The non-real-time part, aside from the C++ and the SQL interfaces, which are available there as well, allows you to program the system in JavaScript, which is relatively unique in industrial automation. And we offer that because we believe that JavaScript, as a very modern programming language, allows you to get more developers to implement your applications, because the number of developers that know JavaScript is a lot higher than the number of developers that know like C++ or IEC 61138. In order to do a project with the system, you need a project engineering system. This is what basically is the interface for the engineers, and it allows you to design the model that your system will operate. It creates the process variables, which describe static and dynamic behavior of the system. And it allows you to deploy the system to the target system and to analyze what is going on your target system. If we talk about the application of flex control in a smart factory, we have to ask ourselves, what is a smart factory? Smart factory means all equipment talks to each other, and you have an entire view of everything which is going on in the factory. But this is not always the case. If you have existing equipment, which may be 5, 10, 15, or 20 years old, it will not talk to you. It's too old. And flex control can act as a bridge, which allows you to make that data available also from existing equipment and from new system, and integrate it into one concentrated data platform. If you have that, you can do all sorts of interesting things. As an example, you can configure, analyze, and identify data trends, and you can make predictions with classic approaches and also AI approaches. And that could be used, for instance, to optimize cost for purchasing gas, for instance, by using historic data and trends. And it is also possible that you can make the flex control part of your own application. You can embed flex control into your own system, deeply embedded, and that allows you that instead of programming lots of standard features for the data management, it will be replaced by configuring the system and do the standard tasks of data acquisition, data storage, data validation, etc. And that would be the embedded SCADA systems use case for your own devices. Of course, we needed to select a data management platform, and we finally decided to go with ETRDB. And here are some reasons why we did that. First of all, ETIDB offers the replication high availability features, which is very important for us. We use it for online replication of the storage media redundancy. And we can use it also to synchronize between the two tiers. This is basically to protect the customer's data from hardware failures. The DB console is an important feature of EDRDB because it allows us to do prototyping database schemas without writing code. It was used as a debugging tool during development phase. And it is also used at runtime because it allows you to build some functions of the system using scripts, which means you don't have to learn C++ programming. You don't have to learn other things. You can simply use scripts to work with the data. And of course, there's performance, very important feature. In particular, we have a continuous data stream coming into the system, which needs to be stored without data loss. And at the same time, we have multiple concurrent queries running, which must not interfere with the data storage. And ETIDB, we found, has a very robust and fine-grained locking mechanism, which allows that these two things interact seamlessly. So today, FlexControl uses ETIDB for historic data storage, for historic alarms over very long time periods, sometimes the entire device lifetime, which can easily be 15 years. And we also use it for the logging subsystem, because this makes it easy for the maintenance engineers to gain an overview what is going on in the system if there is any problem or troubleshooting. The future shows that we are going to include security features. Also, cross-platform features of ETIDB are interesting for us. And of course, the time series and data streaming engine that Mr. Montasseri has presented. And for us as a customer, it's very good to know that there is a clear product roadmap, which allows us to do a safe project planning and to make sure we have a continuous product evolution of FlexControl and rely on the product delivery by ETIDB. So with these thoughts, I'm thanking you for your attention, and I'm also available for questions, and I'm passing it back to Mr. Montasseri. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Altman. It was very interesting to learn about a very powerful system that is built with ETIDB, and we want to thank all of you for joining us today, and we want to respect the time that we have allocated for this event. So at the end, if you have any questions, we have received several questions, but with respect to the fact that we promised this to be a 45 minutes event, we will communicate with you where we are emailed and answer those questions. So simply write to info@etia.com. and ask us the questions that you have with regard to this webinar. And the best thing here is that, you know, quite frankly, you'll be working with our consultant at no cost. And these are experts in the field with, you know, over 20 years of experience that they can brainstorm with you with regard to data management possibility, see what you have in mind and offer feedback. Thank you very much for joining us. And we wish everyone a wonderful morning, afternoon, or evening, per wherever you are located in the world. Goodbye.
Thank you. Goodbye.